Top 5 Best presents, Grandfather sees note written on his meal receipt and quickly feels sick to his stomach. To give yourself just a bit of a pick-me-up, subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell to experience more shocking stories just like this one every day. Have you ever had a poor experience at a restaurant? We've all had at least one. Most of the time, a quick discussion with the waiter or manager should resolve any issue that may come up, but sometimes that doesn't quite settle the problem. There are certain issues that are just so unacceptable that mere apologies don't feel like enough. When confronted with those issues, it is important to remain level-headed and understand that the restaurant does not have any more avenues for you to escalate the situation. Restaurants seek to de-escalate as much as possible, and so will do whatever to keep you from taking your grievances any further. And of course, there is always the option just to forgive and forget. But if you'd like to see some form of justice, perhaps these next stories will be of use to you. Dinner with the family should be a relaxing experience. When you've got good food and good conversation, there's a little more you can ask for. So when a man from New York went out one evening for dinner, he had no idea the experience would be one that would scar him for the rest of his life. As part of a celebration, an NYC man went out to dinner with his daughter and granddaughter. The restaurant was a comfortable local spot and everyone expected to leave the joint with full bellies. But when the check arrived after dinner, a message printed on the receipt made everything come to a screeching halt. The full belly quickly turned into a sick to the stomach feeling. On June 17th, 2018, Curtis Mays enjoyed a Father's Day dinner with his daughter and granddaughter at the Bohemian Hall Beer Garden in Astoria, Queens. On a beautiful, warm evening with his family by his side, the evening seemed nothing but pleasant. At least, at the beginning it did. The waitress, Curtis recalled, was very nice. She comes up to the table saying, "Hi, how are you doing?" with a smile on her face. He ordered a fat cheeseburger, well done with toasted bread. Unbeknownst to him though, this was the start of a downhill spiral. When the waitress brought out the food, Curtis was handed the wrong dish, so he politely flagged the waitress to have it sent back to the kitchen. As he and his family finished eating, he asked for the receipt to make sure he hadn't been charged for the incorrect dish. Below his burger on the receipt, someone put a special request for the chef. It read, "Please spit in it too." Curtis left, was repulsed. "I ate my burger already," he said. "I felt like I was gonna throw up." So he called the waitress over. "I asked the server," Curtis said. "Why would you do this?" And she couldn't explain it. She said she didn't do it. So I was like, "Who prints out the receipt?" The waitress said that she did. This enraged Curtis. "So you did it?" Curtis demanded. At a loss for words, the waitress just walked away. Appalled at the situation and the waitress's response, Curtis called for the manager, who nodded along as he recounted the story. The manager asked, "How can we compensate you?" But Curtis didn't have an answer. I was like, "How can you compensate somebody for spitting on your food? I ate this already." A platter of cheeseburgers wouldn't cut it, so what would? Despite never having a problem with the waitress before, the manager fired her. Somehow, that nasty message ended up on the order slip. And, at the very least, either she or the chef should have caught it. What's more, the manager compensated Curtis for the Father's Day dinner. Though judging by Curtis's disgust, the refund didn't exactly make his night. Still, the manager assured him it was unlikely the chef actually spit in his food. At the end of the day, Curtis handled the situation with extreme grace. Others who have potentially had their food spit in have pursued more aggressive solutions. Take another New Yorker, Ken Yerden, for instance. Ken and his wife Julie dined at a busy Chili's in Clay, New York, back in July of 2014. Unfortunately, the couple's dining experience was less than ideal. Their food was undercooked, and they never received the fries they ordered. Then, before they left the Chili's, the couple asked for drinks in a to-go cup. "We weren't rude or anything," Ken Yerden said. In fact, when they left the restaurant, they handed their waiter, 24-year-old Gregory Lamica, a nice tip. But on the drive home, the lid to Ken's to-go drink popped off the styrofoam cup. The cops knocked on Gregory's door to question him. Again, he denied he spit in the drink, and he agreed to a DNA swab to prove it. 3 months later, authorities received the DNA test results. The tests confirmed Ken's suspicions. It was, in fact, Gregory spit on the inside of the cup. So police brought the young man down to the station. There, the waiter confessed. He did spit in the cup. The courts charged him with disorderly conduct and sentenced him to a 1-year conditional discharge and a $125 surcharge. But Ken wasn't done. A year after the incident, Ken filed a lawsuit against Gregory, Chili's, and the owner of that specific restaurant's location for negligence and retention of an incompetent employee. As a final note, Ken added, "We won't be going back to Chili's." In the end, we've all had some pretty bad experiences at a restaurant before, but spitting into someone's food is abhorrent and disgusting. If your waiter or waitress is willing to resort to such an action, they can't be upset if you choose to escalate the issue. We here at Top 5 Best believe in conflict resolution, but we can't tell people how to react to something so disgusting. Hopefully, something like that never happens to you. Thank you for watching. Tap one of the two videos on the screen for another shocking story.